Hi everyone, today we're going to cover how you can do a LTE network survey in an in-building office such as here with the PRiSM handheld scanner and the iBwave mobile survey app. First, let's start take a look at the PRiSM scanner. It comes in this nice case. The scanner itself is very small, lightweight, easy to carry. You will have a USB key as well, and the antenna to connect with it. And this is your whole scanner solution. Very simple to set up. On your device, you will have also a magnetic piece to attach to your device, which will connect your scanner just like this, so you don't need to carry it. Connect with the USB cable and you're ready to go. Here, I have my application open with my project already created and my floor plan imported. First, I'll make sure the right settings are on. Airplane mode should be turned on with Wi-Fi off, and the Ethernet cable connection should be enabled. This will allow the scanner to communicate with the application and do our survey. Here, I have the survey tab open. There's the new survey button, the first button in the tab. This will be used to create or configure our survey. Make sure the scanner is selected. We have two modes, stop and go and continuous. First, we'll cover how to do a blind scan. And for the blind scan, I recommend stop and go. Under the LTE technology, you have your list of bands. Select the bands you want to do a blind scan for. In this case, I have band 2 and 4. And don't select any specific channels. Leave it at as is. And you're ready to start a survey. As you can see, I have a message letting me know that B2 and B4 will be doing blind scans. The process is the same as a survey. You place a survey point. Now the scanner will start initializing. And once the blind scan starts, it'll start examining all the channels inside of the bands that we have selected. So band 2 and band 4 have about 1,000 channels. Once it's done, this will turn green. If you click on the plan, you will get a little snack bar that will let you know about the progress. In this case, we're at channel 299 out of 1,050. Once this point is done, you can move forward or stay at the same spot and click to have another point. You need a minimum of 2 points to be able to complete this blind scan survey and go to the floor plan. For the demo, we will fast forward this blind scan to have 2 points completed. This will go fast. Once you are done, simply click on the done button on the top right. Application will ask, you are sure you want to complete this. Okay, now click on the survey point. You can view all of the results gathered in that point. On the left is the information currently displayed on the floor plan. So we have B4, channel 2050 with PCI 254. On the right side, we have a table showing all the other collected channels and PCIs for our selected bands. We have channel 2050, 2325, and channel 900 on the separate PCIs. Same thing for the other point. We have some captured data. In this case, at that location, we can see that the channel 900 was not captured. Now that we've done our blind scan and discovered some channels of interest, let's start a complete LTE survey to test the coverage for those specific channels. Back to the new survey config panel. We're going to open the dropdown for channels. This time, type some specific channels. We'll go with 900 and the 2325. Pay attention that these are selected. If you unselect them, then they won't be part of your survey. And we'll also change our survey mode to continuous since we want to do a straight walk without having to put the survey points each time. So this will automatically fill up your walk with survey data, and you only click on your floor plan to specify pivot points. Let's get started. Similar to my blind scan, I will start from the same spot. Same process, the scanner must initialize. This is faster when it's not a blind scan. Once the point goes green, I will start my walk. And once it's green, now I will start walking. Straight lines, and every time I want to turn around, I'll place my pivot points on the floor plan by placing them exactly where I am turning. And this will automatically place all of the gathered collected data between those two last points. And now that I have completed my survey, I will press done, complete the survey, and import it back to my floor plan so we can analyze the collected measurements. Here, we can see that the interpolation button is automatically toggled when you come back to your floor plan, and this is creating this interpolated heat map of our collected data. We have a legend, which is in the rainbow color. The hotter colors represent a higher power of signal, while as the colder colors all the way to the black represent a weak signal. On top, we have this filter. If you drop it down, you have your technology selector, which is the combination of your technology and the band. And for that selection, you'll have the list of channels available. And for that, you'll have your list of PCIs available. So you can look at specific PCIs and how they result on your floor. For instance, PCI 27, 43, or 219. Here with 219, we can see that this cell is active on one side of the office and not present on the other side, for instance. You can also choose between the KPIs you want to see and interpolated. We have RSSI, NIR, RSRQ, and RSRP. And same as the blind scan, the survey data points can be viewed individually as well. If you click on one of them, you will have the information about the displayed cell on the floor plan, which is interpolated on the left, and you have your table showing you all of the other collected data for that survey data point. And this wraps it up for our demo today of LTE survey with the PRiSM scanner and iBwave mobile.